Hello, everybody. Welcome to this little video. That's more of a, you know, realization of mine, if anything else. And it's about the odd game design that I'm faced with replaying WoW. So I've been trying, I think, for four times to play Season of Discovery. But while I'm very happy that, you know, my friends and the most dedicated players are enjoying Season of Discovery, it's just not for me. I don't like the ramping up of Classic. It's as if I'm playing World of Warcraft on crack. So yeah, no, I'm not feeling it, unfortunately. However, I am having a lot of fun with just plain old Classic. And you know why? It's because, especially at level 40, I kind of forgot what this game was about, but I also have these flashbacks of what it was about, because I played a warrior in Classic. And playing a warrior in Classic, I don't know how I did it, but I did it. I got to level 60 right before the Burning Crusade came out. It was just real timing, so it's kind of cool. My vanilla WoW experience was characterized by essentially playing World of Warcraft Classic. I didn't play Endgame, unfortunately. After that, I immediately started playing the Burning Crusade, and then I got really interested in PvP. So I've actually played PvE in World of Warcraft vanilla, and then right after got into PvP, and then Wrath of the Lich King, I started to raid a little bit, and I zoned out on Cataclysm. I returned to WoW. I mean, I played a bit of Mists of Pandaria, but I didn't like it. I skipped Forts of Draenor, and I returned during Legion. And during Legion, I actually took the raiding a little bit more seriously. So I'm here to rectify that by replaying Classic WoW and doing... I want to kill Kalthazar, essentially. So, first of all, I have to get through this level 40 search. Because the weird thing about level 40 is... it seems to go a lot slower, and there's no specific area where you need to level. I'm pretty sure I need to finish up Stranglethorn Vale, as I'm doing now. But Stranglethorn Vale on PvP is insanity. I grouped up with this lad only because it's like insurance. So... And I read online that from level 40 to 50 is almost like level 1 to 40 in time-wise. And then 50 to 60 is a breeze. But I don't really remember that in my Classic WoW era. Alright, being summoned. Oh, All right, I'm being randomly invited to do Razor from Downs, so that's pretty cool. Hey, everyone. If I just go to Booty Bay, no, I think I just have to get out of here. Wow, RFD. I'm a returning player. Wow, guys, we're going to Razor from Downs. I literally haven't been there since 2005. Actually, what I need to do now, I'm fucking up. I need to go to Booty Bay and take the boat.
What can I do for you? Go with.
I wonder how these guys, because it happens to me a lot that as a frost mage I get a message like, hey man, you wanna come? You wanna join? So I just wanna know what that is. How do you guys find me? I get a lot of DMs. Dungeon runs. Scour zones for a mate. Well, it you know, yeah, okay, so he does. He scours the zones for a mage. And to be fair, playing a mage, I respect Frost Mage, obviously, but it's, guys, it's such an insane thing to do, because the whole game just, I mean, it ups in efficiency, really. I've never played a mage. Never played mage before, except for Dragonflight. Gotta say, it's like I'm playing a cannon. Respect the Frost recently as well. It does seem a little bit like, I understand that the mage is cool, but the damage output, if you look at the maintenance a warrior has to do for his gear, and, you know, as a warrior, we're going to check that today, because in my mind, a warrior doesn't really do that much predictable damage. Back for having a warrior at level 40, by the way. So weird. I don't really do alts. I mean, right now I might, if I look at retail, I think I have a lot of alts, but that's sort of how the game works. In Classic, no, I only play Warrior. And same with now that I'm back, I'm only playing this character. I tried to get into Season of Discovery, but... Always been playing Warrior. So... Most fun endgame class, in my opinion. Yeah, I suppose if you're into the aesthetics and, you know, the bragging rights, I think a well-geared warrior is the best thing in WoW. Look at him. This guy, level 53. Look at him. Look at him. Just doesn't give a fuck. What's he carrying? Axe of Rinji. A one hand. Oh, alright, so it's a tank. Bragging rights. Incoming. I wonder what the actual difference is between a warrior and a paladin in retail. I don't even know. I mean, I think it's safe to say that a fury warrior does more damage because of the dual, the two-handed dual capabilities. Oh, what's he doing? Wow. Let me make him some bread. Oh yeah, this is exactly the place. Okay. Almost there, peeps. It's not mean. It's justice. Haha, yeah. STP is... It's different. I think I just gotta walk, really. Yeah. But Regin is pretty scary because you can see them sort of lingering in the back. Alright, now it seems to be safe enough. Lots of lions on this realm. Nice, nice. Oh, there he is. Wow. Okay, the alliance just took over. Very good. Also, I forgot Razor Fan Downs. In terms of tactics, isn't it the place for a warrior quest? Quest? Incense! My. Savannah Prowler. You know what I like about World of Warcraft? It is both sword and sorcery as classical fantasy. If you go for the Horde, you're more in a sword and sorcery kind of realm. And if you go for classical fantasy, you're more in the Alliance realm. But add to the fact also that when you play the first two expansions, with the addition of Outland, you're also playing a subgenre that's called Sword and Planet, because in Outland you have some very distinct science fiction elements as well as fantasy, and I think that those combined really correlate into what makes World of Warcraft pretty awesome, at least for the first three expansion. I heard something. I'm gonna ask them. So, are they going to relaunch Geta? Because I hate that. The only thing that's sort of missing in World of Warcraft is a sort of steampunk setting. I think they've tried to do it with Blackfeather, or what's called Bell for Azeroth, at those elements a little bit. Maybe Cataclysm as well, with the Grey Manes. But other than that, Wandering Baron's Giraffe. All right. Man, the Barons, for a change, for a change. I'm thinking of creating a new D&D setting where the starting zone is more like sword and sorcery, then goes over to classical. Well, I actually need to rework my homebrew, because what I want to do is I'm playing, you know, if you have seen other videos on my channel, you can see that I'm playing Starfinder Homebrew, and it's really fun, but it's too science fictiony for what I had homebrewed. So what I want to do is I want to finish this homebrew setting, and I want to rework the order of arcs and play a mixture of astonishing swords and swordsmen of Hyperborea and Traveler. So that may sound odd to those in the know because Traveler is hard science fiction, whereas astonishing swords and sorcery is sword and sorcery, a little bit sword and planet. Because what I want to achieve is create a world where sword and sorcery and sword and planet meet. And I also have a couple of static ideas, but what I'm picturing is first starting out with a sword and sorcery setting, so I can play a lot of horde characters to gain inspiration for that. After that, I would probably go into classical fantasy, then get on with some steampunk, diesel punk, and sword and planet. Because now I did steampunk, diesel punk. I based it off of Silvermar in WoW, but I made a steampunk setting out of it. Oh wait, I have to get off the road, I think. Probably need to get off the road, right? Cosmic monkey. Huh? Your monkey shows the way. Yeah, I think it's interesting to do that, what I just said. So now I started off with the diesel punk setting based off of Suramar. Then I went into classical fantasy, and now we're at Sword and Planet. But they seem to like it, by the way. Oh no. Oh shit. Fucking hell. Fucker had a mount as well. Balmodan. Right, I'm caffeinated and ready to go. Cosmic monkey. I don't understand any of this. Who is he? So, what? So the rogue is on his. Okay. Could have fooled me, but. Alright. Whoa. I forgot how good this looks. Horde territory. Maybe classical fantasy. Thank you. Thank you. All right, this is going to be some nice experience, I hope. Pretty solid group, I suppose. Two rogues. All right, I got the jade. Oh. Maybe ask for quests? Share queues, maybe? I want to know. Funny how this works, right? I started the video saying how complicated it is to level, but like in 5 minutes of starting this video, I'm being invited to this awesome dungeon. And I gotta say, this is very easy. Man, the range on this mage. Oh shit. Chamber. Got him. Alright, let's see if we can do something about this. Shit.
How generous.
Right, very meticulous positioning here. Shit. Pretty sure I don't touch that gong. Right? Whoa! Wait, arcane explosion might work here. I need to conjure different water. I thought I could, but... Two bottles, that's nothing. Yeah. Sorry. Alrighty. Thinking of making yeah, I have a pretty cool idea actually. I'm thinking of creating a Blood Elf Death Knight. I think that's it, yeah. And make him like L. Oh, shit. I should also buff the priest. Fuck. Dispel, yeah. Pretty scary dungeon. Not gonna lie. And I mean, what I love about this dungeon is that it sort of makes sense for them to live here. There is something about the brambles, it covers from a lot of things. Like it's the ultimate defense. But it's so shitty to live in there that only these pig people can call it home. Okie dokie. Arthas tears. Holy shit. Man, a mage is pretty handy. Whoa. Oh shit. More Dresh Fire Eye. I don't need it. Well, I can't have a break here. All right, let's do this then. The murder pen. I can actually already see how this dungeon might fit into my current arc. Oh shit! So this is a race? Jesus.
That's still recharging.
This is awesome. I love this. This is all I want in a game. I mean, I didn't even know I had the skill, to be honest. Fucking hell. Alright. I'm back. Oh, shit. Get him in place. Snarky snark. Shit. Should not have done that. I wish I had the normal conjure water. I'll wait. Oh, thank you. Thank you. main battery on him. Whoa. Holy shit, that looks cool. Oof. I'm just gonna join in. Okay. Okay. Splinterbone Centurion. Funny how I might do that for my Starfinder homebrew, by the way. I wanna. So I set. It's funny how there's an uneven amount. I don't need it. Maybe I need to introduce, like, elite in my homebrew campaign, because at level 17 they're killing everything. So maybe an elite is like 20% increase of attack and armor and health. Pretty good setup. Have the rogues confuse one, then have the warrior charge in, barrage with the mage, have the priest heal and buff. Green flame. Thank you. Summoner goes first. Makes sense. What a nice return to WoW. I always have a deal. If I dream about WoW, I play it again. Memnar, the cold bringer. Immune. Okay.
I am the hand of the Lich King.
It's probably just fireball. Okay.
Come, spirits.
How interesting. Talk about an interesting turn of events. This is where they all live, right? In their little nooks and crannies. Yeah, sorry. I don't know how it works. Gotta wait 2 minutes before I can head out. Okay. One and a half minute, then I'll be ready to Hearthstone out of here. Storm layer. Cool. Ice armor. Oh, shit. Oh, that's way better. Oh shit.
It's still recharging.
There we go. And maybe we can already sort of figure out what to do with those portals. Although, I'm good with a Hearthstone. It's just those utilities might be smart to invest in. Given that my worth as a mage is, significant, I must say. Whoa. To sell, what to buy. I think I'm gonna sell shit first. I think that might be smart. And I think I'm just gonna buy every class related thing before I invest in a mount. It's odd to me that I didn't do any of this.
I supply only the finest goods.
Hey. Thank you. That's a lot of money. Wait, let me Google that. Speckle turtle shell. Speckled shell. Speckled shell fragment. Yeah, look. Yeah, lekker. Fijn. All right.
See you later.
Oh, thank you. See if we can. Probably need to store that sword. Whoa.
Outstanding.
Manual of Heroic Strike, huh? You flatter me, young mage. Man, everyone is having the coolest shit.
Greetings.
Uh-huh.
For the Alliance.
I'm eating soup, so I'm gonna turn off the mic for a sec.
Hello. Have a good one. Be careful. Safe travels. Farewell. What can I do for you? See you around. I am listening.
Well met. King King's honor, friend. Be careful.
Need help? Go with honor, friend. Well met. Be careful.
Hello. Have a good one.
Okay, I'm back. I had to eat a little bit. I'm gonna look for portals here. Malice in Wonderland. Okay, okay, okay.
Welcome to the Cathedral of Light.
Well, fuck. I just did. Oh, really?
Be at peace.
Oh, wow. What the hell? I've never been here. What? Okay. No portal vendor to be found. Who? Ah, shit. Okay. It's arcane trinkets. Brother Cassius.
Light be with you.
Okay. And now, if I...
The Alliance.
Rune of Portals. Rune of Teleportation. Alright. Rune of Teleportation. Eldric Voucher. Arcane Goods Vendor in the Trade District. Okay. Never seen this before. Cool little detail. And I think we're going back to Stranglethorn Vale and work on that Skull Splitter quest. It's a good use of my time. Dagon, Earthshaker. Cool. Should I go? Arcane Goods Vendor. Fuck. Okay. Should be here, but
good day to you.
Hello.
Safe travel.
Greetings. Light bless you.
Oh, well, we can just go here then, I think. A place called Arcane Trinkets. Essential components. No. Apothecary. Okay. Go to the toilet. Be right back. Hello?
Yo, yo, yo!
Yo.
Zo. Ja, droog filmpje van Indiana Jones. Ja,
heel goed, inderdaad. Inderdaad. Ik vroeg me af. Het leek namelijk op Flash Kids, maar dat is het niet.
Ja, maar het is wel met een soort van stijltje waar wat in de buurt zit, hè?
Flash Kids! Ja, vond het leuk.
Ja.
Oké. Okay.
Wat ook een leuke dude is, Meat Canyon. Maar dat is echt wel een beetje punzige shit. Maar...
Oh, dat ken ik.
Ja.
Ja. Ja, daar heb ik van gehoord.
Papa Meat.
Ja, ik geloof dat ik het ken.
Maar ik zou deze wel, Angel Gaines zou ik even doen. Die zou ik even sturen. Die is echt nasty.